Hey guys, so if you are new here, my name is Deb and welcome. If you are not new here, you are probably thinking to yourself, hey, what happened to that No By July? Well, if you're not new and you're subscribed to me, you know how much I love Wet n Wild, and there was no way I was going to pass up this collection. This is Wet n Wild's Fall 2018 collection. It is called Fire Dragon versus Ice Dragon. And if you've seen the pictures already, then you might think that it reminds you a little bit of sort of a Game of Thrones type situation. But yeah, I came across this display and there was just no way that I could not buy this because I collect all the Wet n Wild limited edition collections. So without any further ado, let's get into it because this is a big collection and this is not a review, but I want to give you as much information as I can about what I know so far about the products that I have used because I haven't used every single thing yet. I just got the collection. I got some of it the day before yesterday, then I went back yesterday and bought some more things. All right, so let's start with what this collection is. This collection is a dragon theme. The imagery on the packaging, some of the things have dragons on them, some of them have other symbology that is tied to that theme. It's more or less divided into fire versus ice, so you get a nice combination of colors. So let's start with the eyeshadow palettes. There are four of them. I'm going to show you the two fire dragon ones first. The first one is called Fit for a Queen, and this is what it looks like. So you get a gold and a burgundy, and then sort of a pinky rose highlighter shade, and of course your transition shade is at the top. This is their new way of doing palettes, and I love that they do this. It makes it so handy to have a transition shade in every palette so that you can blend between colors if you need to. It's Wet n Wild is just killing it lately, and I'm so happy with everything they've been putting out. So that is the first one. Now, in terms of pigmentation or blendability and all that, I haven't used this palette yet. So, I can't really tell you anything about it. Those are the four colors swatched. I'm not going to do arm swatches or anything like that because I am a firm believer that you really don't know how a product is going to perform until you actually try to use it on your eyes. Just doing finger swatches or arm swatches doesn't really tell you what you need to know. And when I get to the palette that I actually have used, I will give you a prime example of what I mean. So that is Fit for a Queen. So that's one of the Fire Dragon eyeshadow palettes. Sometimes when I do swatches, finger swatches like that, I'll just dust off my fingers quickly, like on my arm or something, and I wasn't able to do that this time because those shadows were very pigmented. Okay, the next one from the fire side is called Dragon Scales. And this looks exactly like you would imagine a dragon scales palette to look like. You have two shades of green, a beige, and your transition shade. So let's do some finger swatches of that. Because I haven't used this one yet either. Yeah, that definitely makes me think of dragons. And now for the two palettes that are on the cool side, we have the Knight's Quad. And this one consists of a silver, a black, sort of a ivory shade for the highlight, and your transition shade. That transition shade is pretty light, so this would probably be your best option for a lighter skinned person. Otherwise, that transition shade would, I think, be too light for most people. So those are the four shades finger swatched. So that black, when swatched with my finger, is pretty soft, I would say. It's not like a really dark black. And then last but not least, the fourth palette and the second on the cool side is called Mythicool Creatures. And this is the one that I am wearing. So you get a purple, a blue, a beige, and your transition shade. And as far as what I can tell you about the shadows and how they worked, the purple shade was somewhat difficult to apply. So I put it on, that's what I have like in the first inner two-thirds of my lids. Yeah, it was somewhat difficult to apply, but then I switched to a different brush and it was fine. And what's odd is both brushes were synthetic bristles. So I don't know why that was. And of course I used an eyeshadow primer. And then the crease shade, the blue, was so pigmented that I had trouble blending it out because it was so dark. And I have that on the outside part of my lids, the crease, and along the lower lash line. And then I didn't use the highlighter shade because I had wanted to use one of the other products in this collection. And I did use the transition to blend between my brow bone highlight and my crease shade, and that worked very nice. And I might as well do some swatches of this too, even though I'm wearing it. So you can see that this blue is super pigmented, and then, you know, you can't even really tell which one is the purple. But I believe it is the pinky finger. So yeah, I really had to build up that lid shade, which is a shame because if it had gone on easily, it would have been nice. But I was able to get that color, but I had to really build it up. Okay, and there are four pigments. And you know I love pigments, so I'm so happy that they've been doing more pigments, or just doing pigments at all, because I don't remember them doing pigments except for, you know, the last 3 years, I would say. So there are two warm colors and two cool colors, just because, you know, that's the theme. So for the warm colors, we have Fire Rain. So that is Fire Rain. And I love their design on their pigments. Everybody should do them this way. They're just so easy to work with. So I'll just do... So there's Fire Rain. And then the next shade on the Fire Dragon side is called Gilded Crown. And it's a gold. It's pretty. It's kind of a softer gold, and I was expecting it to be more of an antique type gold. Actually, okay, there's the true color right there. And then on the Ice Dragon side, I have Ice Ice Lady. And this is a pale silver, I would say. And I use this as my brow bone highlight and inner corner highlight because I wanted to incorporate it into today's look. But I will still do a swatch anyway. Wham. This is an intense one, you guys. And I think that you can see where I missed wiping off one of those other swatches. But yeah, this is an intense one, you guys. And I think if you're going to do any kind of a cool tone look, you would absolutely love this for a brow bone highlight or inner corner highlight the way I used it today. Or you could use this as a face highlight if you wanted to. And then the last shade of pigment is called Tonight's Blue. And I used this yesterday. I didn't film a video yesterday, but I used this in the eyeshadow look that I did yesterday, and it was really pretty. So that's what that looks like. Tonight's Blue. Okay, and there are two face highlighters, and they're both cool. So they didn't do a warm and a cool for this. They did two cool. And the first one is called Winter Falls in LA. And this has an imprint of a dragon on it. So you can see there's a dragon and his tail, and then there's like the sun in the middle, and then like little tendril things coming off of the dragon, but really, really pretty. So this is just a white bordering on silver highlighter. It has a duochrome to it, though, and the duochrome is blue. That's off the finger swatch. So, yeah, this is pretty intense. Oh, it's what I have for my face highlight. Or did I use the other one? Oh, boy. I don't remember which one I use now. Oh no, because I always list all the products that I'm wearing in the description box, so I don't know which one to put. I think, yeah, I have that white one on. Okay, the other one is called Halo Walkers, and this one is a very cool blue. So there's the finger swatch. And there is the finger swatch onto the hand. Who does highlighters better than Wet n Wild? And at such affordable prices. Unbelievable. I'm so glad I came across this collection. Oh, by the way, I should tell you where I bought it. I got it at Christmas Tree Shop. And the three places that people have seen and purchased this collection so far are Christmas Tree Shop, Bed Bath & Beyond, and Harmon Drugstores. All Bed Bath & Beyonds and Christmas Tree Shops do not carry makeup, but the ones that do most likely have this out, because everybody that has those stores near them, the ones that do carry makeup, is finding it. I didn't have to go to multiple stores to get this. I just found it at my local store. All right, the next thing I'm going to show you are probably my favorite things in the collection. If I could only buy one thing, this is what I would get. The brushes. Both these brushes are from the Pro line. And the first one is P53, and it is a bronzer brush. Look at the detail, you guys. It has a dragon's tail, and it's like a ruby red color, and the bristles on this are so soft. I haven't used this yet because I wanted it to look perfect when I showed it to you, but I did wash it though, And after it has been washed and dried, it still feels super soft and the shape maintained itself and no bristles came out when I washed it. So that's a good sign. And then it has the little indentation on the side, like all the pro brushes do, where you can put your finger when you hold it. So I can't wait to use that. I wanted to use it today so bad, but like I said, I wanted these brushes to look as perfect as possible. Okay, the next one is the P77 brush, and this is a highlighter brush, and it has white bristles on it instead of brown, and it has a silver and blue handle with the dragon's tail. It just goes down, descending, smaller and smaller. Wet n Wild is just killing it. I love this collection so much. So these would be my favorite things, but we also have lipsticks. We have four lipsticks. We have two fire lipsticks that have gold packaging with flames on them. And then we have two ice-themed lipsticks that have icicles at the top with silver packaging. So for the fire lipsticks, we have Queen's Blood, which is a copper. This is the only one I haven't tried yet because I just got the lipsticks yesterday and I tried one on and then I took that off and tried another one on. And then later on in the day, I tried a third one. So this is the only one that I haven't worn yet. So I can't tell you anything about this application, anything like that. And I'm not going to do swatches of these because you can clearly see the color. You know, it is what it is in the tube. The other fire lipstick is called Redlings. Out of the four lipsticks, this is the one that applied the best. It was flawless, very easy to work with, gorgeous, like cranberry red color. And really like that. The two Ice Dragon ones are Icing on the Wall. This is the one that I'm wearing, and obviously it is a blue. This one, you can make it work, but you have to build it up. You have to do sections at a time, and then as it starts to dry, put like a little more over the areas where it isn't completely opaque, but you can work with it. And then the last one is Shall We Slay? And this is a gray. And just like with the blue one, it was sort of patchy, but you can fix it just by adding more. But I know some people don't want to bother trying to make things work, but to me, it's worth it because you can get full opacity if you're just willing to put a little bit more on. So in the end, it will look good if you just have a little patience. And then there was one more product I bought by Wet n Wild that was not part of this collection, but it is new, and it's their Lash Renegade Amethyst Mascara. Avenging Amethyst. And yesterday I wore this over a black mascara thinking that that would make it pop the best, but I actually think it worked better today just using it on its own. I'm going to look up so you can just see what my lashes look like with this on. So yeah, it's just a purple mascara and I like it. So I'm glad I picked that up too. Now, this collection is not on the Wet n Wild website. Well, at least it wasn't on right before I started filming. I checked and it wasn't on there. So as of right now, it's not on the website. And will it be? I would assume so. It's their fall 2018 collection, but when that's going to happen, I don't know. There is another collection that is coming out very soon from Wet n Wild, and it is the Zodiac collection. If you just type Wet n Wild Zodiac Collection as a Google search, you will come across information about it. It is going to be available on the Wet n Wild website and on Walmart's website. And it will be in stores on August 1st. That collection has 4 highlighters, 12 lip glosses, 1 loose highlighting powder, and it's Zodiac. So it's going to be broken down. The 4 highlighters are going to be Earth, Air, Fire, Water, obviously. And then the loose highlighting powder is going to be for the whole collection, you know, just one color. Then the glosses, because there's 12 of them, there's going to be one for every sign. So how fun is that to buy a lip gloss specially made for your sign? You guys that have been with me for a while know I love astrology. I did a whole series on it, and I created a look for every single one of the signs. That was really fun, and I'm so glad I did that. That was 2 or 3 years ago now, but yeah, that was really fun. But I wanted to make sure I gave you that information so that you would know that as well. If you have enjoyed this video, please consider subscribing to my channel. And if you just enjoyed the video, please give it a thumbs up. And I'll see you next time, guys. Thanks so much for watching. Bye.